समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपराम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणि जाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चित घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यम सुखम नित्यम च प्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वे निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परम तदेवाहन्नमत्तोऽन्यत्ति मे निश्चिता मतिः। फॉर सम रीजन दी स्क्रीन इज नॉट विजिबल, इट इज विजिबल नाउ। ओके, in the third chapter we are looking at the guru and shishya lakshana, mostly guru lakshana, because shishya lakshana has been explained in the first two chapters in anubandha chatushtaya antargata adhikaritvam. So tippana will not look at much here. What is an what is ashtanga pranama that is mentioned here? Guru seva kramaha. So what is the guru seva kramaha? I think just I'll read the last sentence and then move on to the next page because there is a formatting issue. So Shri Sadguru Labha Labhottarakshane Tad Darshana Matrat Tad Darshana Matrat Ashtanga Namaskrutya. ओके, सो अष्टांगं नमस्कृत्य तत् चरण कमल रजांसि परिशुद्धात्मनि सोत्तमांगे धारयेत्। सो दिस इज हाउ टू डू नमस्कार टू दि गुरु। एल्सवेयर इट इज सेड पीपल फील अशेम टू बो डाउन टू दि गुरु इन पब्लिक, सो दे विल डू इट इन क्लोज क्वार्टर्स बट नॉट इन पब्लिक। ऑल दैट हैज टू बी ड्रॉप। सो समर्पण भाव इज मेंशनड हियर। सो वन शुड offer namaskaras as one would do to Bhagavan. Paschat Sadguru Prasadat Bandhamochana Kankshi Tivratara Mumukshuhu Gurukule Brahmachari Vaset. So Antevasi. Antevasi has complete commitment and thereby being in the Gurukula, one gets Jnana. So one should stay after having Guru Darshana. Earlier it was said approaching him with humility as to wanting to learn with an with an attitude of seva samarpana bhava, and then stay in the gurukula for study. Tasmai swasharira mano vag dhanadini samarpayet. And then if one has dhana in the gurukula, of course as a child if one goes for Vedic study one may not have, but otherwise the parents give it. Or earlier the system was that when brahmachari steps out of the ashram and before marriage he is supposed to finish off his commitments of dakshina to the guru and then get married. Further sharirarpanam shri sadguru ho abhimata sushrucham bhautaram krutva managapi tadajnana tilinghanena वर्तनम एव शरीरार्पणम इत्युच्यते। सो अनति अनतिलंघनेन विदाउट ट्रांसग्रेसिंग व्हाट द गुरु हैज सेड इवन मनागपि इवन इन थिंकिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड अ शरीर शरीरार्पणम। इट इज नॉट जस्ट नमस्कार, इट इज नॉट अ योगासन नमस्कार। यू नो पीपल डू सूर्य नमस्कार टू डू नमस्कार टू द गुरु, that is yogasana, it is not namaskara. Namaskara is more with the bhava than with the physical samarpana. So sharirarpanam is what, following the guru in the seva as well as then bahutaram krutva, having done seva then further following guru's teachings and not transgressing even in thought. Mana arpana, what is mana arpanam there? Brahma Vishnu Shivatmaka eva shri sadguruhu न अन्यः इति मनसा निश्चित्य तस्मिन् परमां भक्तिं प्रेमातिशयं च कृत्वा यथा तस्य कृपाकटाक्षः स्वस्मिन् पतेत् तथा तम् अनुवर्तेत। एंड वन शुड द ट्रायड, यू नो ईश्वर हिमसेल्फ अपीयर्स एज ब्रह्म विष्णु एंड शिवा, फॉर व्हाट पर्पस? ब्रह्मा फॉर क्रिएशन, विष्णु फॉर सस्टेनेंस एंड शिवा फॉर डिसॉल्यूशन ऑफ द यूनिवर्स। बट देन देयर आर अदर रोल्स टू प्ले which is the role of the teacher. So he becomes Dakshinamurti also and creates a sampradaya or from Narayana as a teacher. And then the Sadguru Parampara, he himself appears as in the sampradaya as the guru. So Sri Sadguruhu na anyaha Brahma Vishnu Shivatmaka eva iti manasa nishchitya tasmim paramam bhaktim premadishyam chakrutva yatha tasya krupakataksha. So that the guru's glance stays and then there is grace. Swasmin patet. We want guru's grace, therefore we should, you know, just like one looks forward. When one worships Ishvara, he says, you know, please have a kataksha drushti towards me, similarly towards the guru. Swapne api tasmin dosha drushtim na kuryat. There are doshas even, you know, people analyze whether Rama did right when Sita, Mother Sita was sent to the forest. Whether Rama did right is a debate, ongoing debate all the time. Whether or not he was right is a topic of debate, because there are some people who will see dosha even in Rama, let alone the Guru. So being born as a human being, there will be bodily prarabdha which is not his own. In avatars it may not be own, but for the guru it is his own prarabdha. He carries the baggage of the earlier janmas. Although it is said, you know, nadi moolam rishi moolam na pruchet, one should not ask the source of the nadi, look for the source of the nadi or what is the background of the guru, of the rishi. But here there is baggage and the prarabdha will continue in the body, thereby doshas will be there. There will be nobody who is dosha mukta. As I said, even in avataras there are doshas, because avatara itself has come because of samashti prarabdha. Samashti prarabdha, the prayers of the samashti, whoever wanted that kind of an avatara to come down, you know, please save us. With that prayer, the avataranam happens. Then there will be flaws in the body which has been taken by Ishvara to bless the whoever was the bhakta. And here in the case of a human being who is not an avatara per se guru, there will be doshas, but those doshas should not be seen. Even the Shruti says that even if they follow something wrong, you do not follow. So what is taught by the guru should be looked at, but not what guru does. Let the guru be as per his prarabdha, but you follow his teachings. So we should follow the teachings of the guru, not the guru acharana. Although guru acharana should be in sync with it, but then there can be some doshas. Those should be ignored, says the sadhu here. Swapne api tasmin dosha drishtim na kuryat. We don't get much to point out flaws. We are interested in the teaching. Sa eva harihi haraha brahma ganga surya iti vijaniya. And then since Ishvara and Guru we don't see as different, because we want aikya siddhi, And if Guru does not have Aikya Siddhi, how will I get Aikya Siddhi? It is a tall order, you know, that it would be a, you know, it would be a dream to get moksha, but thinking that the Guru is full of doshas. That does not work for us. So for our selfish interest itself, at least we should surrender unto Guru as Ishwara. Niratishaya Kshemarthi Mumukshu Shri Sadguru Swarupam Hridhidharayan Sadatameva Dhyayet. And then Ishwara Dhyana and Guru Dhyana are not different, because earlier it was said Ishwara Puja and Guru Puja are not different. So people who are benefited, the Shishyas, the real Shishyas, would start doing Dhyana on the Guru. Etat Sarvam Manarpanam Uchyate, and that itself is called as Manarpanam. What is Vagarpanam? Yanyasmagam Sucharitani Tani Toyopasyani Na Itarani. So one that I just recalling, Taittiriya Upanishad says, whatever Guru teaches, that should be followed, not what Guru follows. So Yani Asmakam Sucharitani Tani Toyopasyani, and even in what the Acharana is, in the Acharana also, what is Shushtu Achara? Shushtu Charitani means Shushtu Achara. Those alone should be followed. Let's say if Guru gets angry and scolds someone, why also, you know, Guru is angry and he scolds, I should also keep on scolding people? That should not be the following. So, what is in keeping with Dharma, those should be followed. There may be some doshas, those should be ignored, those should not be followed at least. Even if we can't ignore initially, we should not follow them. Ityadi Shrutyukta Prakarana Shri Sadguru Prarabdha Karmadhina Shariradi Gata Gunagana Kirtanam Antara Tan Nishtha Doshanam Anucharanam Meva Vagarpanam Uchyate. Not talking about the Guru's doshas, that itself is Vagarpanam, because discounting them as the Sharira Gunas, Guna Guneshu Vartante, in that there will be Tamasika Guna also, Rajasika Guna also. Sattva is more obviously, but if it is only Sattva, Guru will not be able to sleep at all. Nobody will be able to sleep. So Tamas is also needed. It is needed when it is needed, not throughout the day. So Sattva Pradhana, then Rajas will be there, otherwise Guru will not be able to even teach, will not be able to do anything. So to act, Rajas is also needed, but those are all secondary. We should let them aside and go with Sattva, where the Guru teaches the Shruti. So not talking about Guru's dosha itself is Vagarpanam. Dhanarpanam, Patni Putra Bhumi Pashudas Dasi Dasa Dravya Grihadhanyana Dhanamiti Loka Prasiddhi. So Ashtalakshmi, whatever, you know, this Patni Putra Bhumi Ityadi, these are all considered as Dhana. Dhana, so Grihadhanyana Dhanamiti Loka Prasiddhi. To beget a good child, Suputra, Suputri, in this era, that itself is grace. That is called as Dhana. Are others able to see the screen?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So the problem set some.
Yes.
Log out and log on again. See if you can see the screen. So that is Dhanarpanam. In the context of Dhanarpanam, Dhana is first inquired into. Loka Prasiddhi is, these are all guna, dhanas, and then, you know, in today's era, you may replace them with whatever is the modern. So Pashu, nobody has Pashu, not many have Pashu today. So Pashu is also considered as Dhana. Etat Sarvam Sanyasya. So having given up, one does not want these dhanas anymore. One cannot want dhana and moksha together. So, etat sarvam sanyasya sharanatvena shri sadguru ho upasadanam eva dhanarpanam uchyate. So, just giving money is not dhanarpanam. What is real dhanarpanam? Dhanarpanam is etat sarvam sanyasya. Giving up the commitment to dhana, this ashtadhana or whatever you consider as valuable otherwise, laukika values, giving them up. Etat sarvam sanyasya sharanatvena, committing, you know, surrendering to the Guru, श्री गुरु श्री सद्गुरु उपसदनम एव बीइंग इन क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी इफ नॉट फिजिकली इन द टीचिंग वॉट एवर द गुरु टीचेस कमिटिंग टू दैट सरेंडरिंग टू दैट टीचिंग इज धनार्पणम धनार्पणम उच्यते संन्यासित्वेन सर्वसंग परित्यागस्य कृतत्वात् कृतार्थः श्री सद्गुरुः न धनादिकं किञ्चिदपि अपेक्षेत शिष्येभ्यः द राइट गुरु विल नॉट एक्सपेक्ट धना फ्रॉम द शिष्यास बिकॉज ही हिमसेल्फ हैज फॉलोड ऑल दिस इन हीज ओन परस्यूट ऑफ ज्ञान ही गेव अप ऑल दी धनास एंड देन सरेंडर टू द गुरु एंड हिज टीचिंग नाउ ही कैनॉट बी एक्सपेक्टिंग धना Which was said earlier also, there was a quotation given as, there are many who will take away the Vittatapaharaka. So, Vittatapaharaka Guru, who, there are so many. But the real Tapa, nobody takes away. Those Gurus are rare. So, here, the Guru is not interested in Dhana. Sarva Sangha Parityagasya. Since he has given up everything, how? Sanyasitvena. With the attitude of sannyasa, if not real sannyasi in ashrama also. Although ashrama sannyasi is preferable. Krutatvat krutartaha. Krutartaha, he has attained everything. Shri Sadguruhu na dhanadikam kinchidapi apekshet. Not even a little. शिष्येभ्यः फ्रॉम द शिष्यास अत एव सर्व परिग्रह त्याग पूर्वकम् स्वार्पणम् एव स्व इज धन दिस इज धन स्वम इज धन बट हियर स्वम इज व्हाट वन सेल्फ सो द शिष्य इज गुरुस धन नाउ बिकॉज शिष्य हैज लर्न्ड व्हाट द गुरु हैज टू टीच अत एव सर्व परित्याग पूर्वकम् स्वार्पणम् एव गुरवे धनार्पणम् इत्युच्यते सो इट नीड नॉट बी स्वम धनम अर्पणम बट स्वम इज वनसेल्फ रिफ्लेक्सिव देयर सरेंडरिंग वनसेल्फ दैट इटसेल्फ इज धन यदि यदि स्यात् गुरुः गृहाश्रमी सो इफ दी ही इज अ गृहस्थ तदा सर्वं धनम तस्मा एव समर्पयेत सो इफ ही इज नॉट अ सन्यासी देन Guru has no livelihood, he is not earning like the others. Thereby, others can give their dhana to him. Ime videhaha aham, ayam aham asmi. Ime videhaha ayam aham asmi. I am one who is without deha. That kind of a guru is, that is a lakshana of the guru. Further, Sir, please switch off your camera. So, Navada Bhakti is mentioned here. Bhakti which was there. In other followings also, Bhakti Sampradaya also, Dvaita Bhakti Sampradaya also, there is Navada Bhakti. The Navada Bhakti in Advaita is what? Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam. This is all Navadaha Bhakti. So listening about the Lord, in Dvaita Sampradaya, listening about the Lord's glories, Kirtanam, singing those Smaranam, remembering them, Padasevanam, worshipping the Lord in the idol or the feet of the Lord, Archanam, So, various types of worshipping, Vandanam, Dasyam, being a servant, and Sakhyam, looking upon the Lord as a friend, and then Atmanivedanam. All that, Iti Tathacha, Uktam Anyatra. All these are Navada Bhakti, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Chaiva, Smaranam, Padasenu, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atmanivedanam, Iti. Now, this can be replaced instead of the Ishvara if you have. If you have Guru also, that is also Navada Bhakti there. Shri Sadguruhu Yada Shishye Prasanno Bhavati Tadasa Vishnu Rupena Vartate. So, why are you saying that Guru is like Shiva, like the triad? There he says, when he is Prasanna with the Shishya, unto the shishya, if guru is prasanna, then he is in the form of Vishnu. Yada kruddha tada shiva rupena. When he is angry, he is like Shiva. Yada rajasavyaparena yuktaha. So rajasavyaparena. Rajasavyaparena is between these. So Vishnu rupa sattva, kruddha rupa is tamas there. Actually it is mixed. It cannot be tamas, cannot be just, you know, anger is not just tamas, there is rajas also. So rajasa vyaparena yuktaha. So there rajas is pradhana. Then what will happen? Tada brahma rupena. Yada prashantaha tada ganga rupena. So ganga has a cooling effect. That's why prashanta swabhava is compared with ganga. Yada vedanta vakya kiranaihi shishya brahma samshayadi savita ajnanam nishyesham nivartayati tada surya rupena chavartateti vijneyam. And when is he like surya? Like the surya takes away tamas, the guru takes away the ajnana of the shishya. So along with the brahma, its effect. Ittham brahma nishte shri sadguru shishyena sakshad ishvara buddhi karya. So one should not differentiate between guru and Ishvara. Svapne api taddosha grahinana bhavyam. So one should not even see, if one keeps on thinking the guru's doshas throughout the waking state, then in svapna it will manifest. So what is said is svapne api, meaning one should not think about it in waking so that it does not come up in svapna. One may not act out in waking, but it will start manifesting in svapna. So one should avoid that in waking so that svapne api tad dosha grahina na bhavyam. Jnana labhaya jnana vaptehe prak guru sevyaha. Guru should be, you know, served before attaining jnana. Paramapi krithagnata dosha nivruttaye guru sevyaha tata cha uktam. If there are krithagnata dosha, all those will go away by seva. Tata cha uktam ado jnana vaptehe paschat कृतज्ञत्व निवृत्तये यावत् जीवं त्रयो वंद्या वेदांतो गुरुरीश्वरः इति. वेदांत गुरु एंड ईश्वर ऑल थ्री आर श्रुति. वेदांत इज श्रुति. गुरु हु लेट्स अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वेदांत सेज एंड ईश्वर हु इज एवरीथिंग अदरवाइज हि इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एवरीथिंग. ऑल दीज थ्री आर यावत् जीवं त्रयो वंद्याः. Even after one becomes a jnani, Vedanta, Guru and Ishvara are worship worthy. Iti. In the Mula, in the end, it was seen as Dhanarpanamya. Dhanarpanam. And Ime Videha Ayam Aham Asmi. Iti Vat. So, like given in the Shruti. Ayam aparaha dhanarpanam prakaraha. So another, the first way is actually offering oneself. That is the dhana sanyasya, sarvam sanyasya. The other is, if the guru is not a sanyasi, then, you know, for his livelihood, giving one's own dhana. Ayam aparaha dhanarpanam prakaraha. That's why in sanyasa, when one takes sanyasa, then one gives up everything. So in that giving everything, dhanatyaga is also included, sarva dhanatyaga. Nacha brahmavit ched guruhu sa katham grihashrami syad iti shankyam. And it should not be doubted that, oh, he is a grihastha. How can guruhu, who is brahmavit, be a grihastha? That should not be doubted. Why? Vasishta vishwamitra vyasa yajnyavalkya uddalaka Ramakrishnadayaha api Shri Sadguravaha grihashrama eva avartanta iti Shruti Smriti Shatebhyo Avagamyate. So you know from Shruti and Smriti that there were so many grihastha teachers. There were so many grihasthas. So grihasthas are not jnani. This is not true. Of course, sannyasa is encouraged. And sannyasa is an outcome, natural outcome, but there may be other reasons for some to continue in the grihastha ashrama also. Meaning non-sannyasa, grihastha is an upalakshana here, other than sannyasa ashrama. there are other reasons also. Technically, if you analyze, of course, here Vishwamitra was an Abrahmana who became a Brahmarshi, but following Vasishta, he wanted to become a Brahmana, looking at Vasishta. So there is a debate, ongoing debate, as whether or not a Brahmana should take, meaning non-Brahmana, meaning Kshatriyas and Vaishyas, should they take, even if they are Dvijas, should they take sannyasa or not? There are multiple opinions there. There are differing opinions between, starting from Bhagavan Bhashyakara, it's Bhagavan Bhashyakara, what he says versus. So there, Bhagavan Appaya Dikshita makes a samanvaya as to, there is an opinion that Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya does not agree with Bhagavan Bhashyakara. He differs by saying that all Dvijas can take sannyasa, whereas Shankaracharya says that only Brahmanas should take sannyasa. This is the reading in the Bhashya. This is how they understand after reading through entire Bhashya, not picky Bhashya reading. So in Gita, if you see something, in Brihadaranyaka, you see something, not picky. There should be samanvaya. Just like we do Shruti samanvaya, similarly, if Bhashya samanvaya is done, if you look at Bhashya entire, what is the mind of Bhagavan Bhashyakara is seen there. So in Sampradaya, it is agreed well, in Orthodox Sampradaya at least, in Orthodoxy, Chaturamnaya Pithas, only Brahmanas are given sannyasa, that too in some Sampradaya, in Sringeri Sampradaya, only Brahmacharis, not even Grahasthas. So there is a certain Sampradaya. We follow the Sampradaya which we belong to. Now, in that also, if you look at Sureshwaracharya, who came after, who was one of the four Shishyas, he in his Vartika, Brihadvartika, he seems to disagree that with Bhashya itself, saying that others can also take sannyasa. But Bhagavan Appaya Dikshita, he analyzes that and he says that there is no difference between the two. What is being said is that Aparoksha Jnana, which is there, Aparoksha Jnana leading to sannyasa versus not having jnana leading to sannyasa, meaning vividisha sannyasa versus vidvat sannyasa. The differentiation is made there, and both are in agreement when they say that the vividisha sannyasa, meaning wanting to get jnana, that kind of sannyasa should be taken only by a brahmana, not by other dvijas. Whereas the sannyasa which can be taken by all is vidvat sannyasa. Even there, the reason Kshatriyas and Vaishyas were asked to continue in their own ashramas is because Kshatriyas and Vaishyas had a bigger role to play for the social good. So that's why Krishna in Gita, he says that in Loka Sangraartham, he tells Arjuna, either you are a jnani, you are an ajnani. If you are a jnani, if you are an ajnani, anyway continue karma yoga. But if you are a jnani even, look at Janakadi and continue in karma yoga so that others benefit. This is not binding on the brahmana, because brahmana karma itself was puja ityadi, and he was not connected in serving the society, in being in the society in such a manner. He was doing the teaching role and the worship, which was his commitment. But Kshatriya had a bigger role to take care of the society, including all the Varnas. All the Varnashrama Dharma also he had to take care. So Kshatriyas were encouraged to continue even after having Vidya, meaning Jnana. Jnani, Kshatriya Jnanis were encouraged to continue. Therefore, Janaka also continued. So in his role, and Vaishyas also because of the economical reasons. And anyway, after Jnanotpatti, it is irrelevant as to the effect of Jnana. Jnana Phala is available anyway, unless one is looking for a higher Bhumika. Sannyasa is not mandatory. Thereby, Kshatriyas and Vaishyas can give up taking sannyasa. That is another way it is looked at. So look, coming back to the context, grahashrami katham brahmavichyed brahmavichyed guruhu katham grahashrami syat iti na shankanyam. So iti na shankyam, one should not doubt that because there are so many examples in Shruti and Smriti. Tasmad grihashrame vartamana api brahmanishta guravah bhaveyuhu. There can be grihastha jnanis also, brahmanishtas also. Shri Sadguru labhanantaram shishyacharana prakara. What should shishya do when he gets a guru? Nishreyasarthina mukshuna purokta prakarna shariradin Shri Sadguruve samarpya तद वसतान्यत्र वा गुरोः समीपे वसता दृढतर आत्म अपरोक्ष साक्षात्कार पर्यन्तं भिक्षाशिना च भाव्यम्. So there are commas put in some places, they may be single words. So having, you know, surrendered oneself completely to the guru, then being an antevasi, दृढतर आत्मा अपरोक्ष साक्षात्कार पर्यंतम. सो अवगति पर्यंतम ज्ञानम. सो दैट ज्ञान परस्यूट ऑफ ज्ञान शुड कंटिन्यू टिल देर इज कल्मिनेशन इन ऐक्य साक्षात्कार अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. सो टिल देन वन शुड कंटिन्यू टू स्टे विद द गुरु एंड देन वन हैज टू सर्वाइव. सो भिक्षाशिना च भाव्यम. वन शुड कंटिन्यू टू लिव ऑन भिक्षा. तांच भिक्षां स्वातंत्रेण भुंजीत. एंड द भिक्षा दैट वन द शिष्यास गेट, दिस इज सेम इन द गुरुकुल इन चाइल्डहुड ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज वेदांत बट इन वेद पूर्व भाग ऑल्सो दिस वॉज द सेम नियम. वन शुड नॉट पार्टेक ऑफ द भिक्षा वन सेल्फ एंड दिस कंटिन्यूज इन गृहस्थाश्रम ऑल्सो. वॉट एवर यू वी हैव अर्न वी शुड शेयर विथ अदर्स बट इन गुरुकुल इट इज टू बी शेयर विथ गुरु. सो श्री सद्गुरु सन्निधौ समर्पयेत. One should offer the bhiksha that one gets to the guru. Shri Sadguru ho anujnya syat chet tad ashaniya ashaniyad bhiksham. Then if the guru says okay you continue, then alone one should partake of the food. Yadi guru ho shishya bhaktyati shay parikshanaya na anumanyet. So the guru may test also at times. Okay, you know, you do upvasa today, then I mean, you know, just he's showing how culturally, how commitment should be. So, you know, just to test the guru, if he says, na anumanyet, tada tushnim eva upavaset. So one should do upavasa and one can remain silent if guru does not say that, okay, you continue. This is true in work life also. If you are in meetings, there are many people who skip lunches. What is the big deal in not skipping a meal if guru does not want you to eat? He is testing you. So, you know, we see this, you know, we follow all this in our work life also, but when it comes to Shastra, we say, why should we do that? So that attitude should be toned down. That's why even in Chandogya Upanishad Shashto Adhyaya, when Shvetaketu comes back home studying all four Vedas very well and faster than the other students, he has a lot of pride. And looking at that pride, his father wants to break that pride. Therefore, he questions him something that he never would have known. Had it not been for the guru, thereby he shatters his pride, that vidya maya, what he has, you know, that I have so much of vidya, all that he shatters. Here also it is, the samarpana bhava is mentioned here. Nacha ekasmin divase द्विभिक्षार्थम ग्रामम प्रविशेत. वन शुड नॉट गो टू विलेज इन द सेम डे ट्वाइस फॉर भिक्षा. भिक्षा शुड बी, यू नो, भिक्षा शुड बी ओनली वंस. ततः नचे एकस्मिन् दिवसे ततः परेद्युः यथाविधि भिक्षाचर्यं चरेत. सो वन शुड कंटिन्यू द भिक्षाचर्य विधि ऑल्सो. वन शुड नॉट गिव अप द विधि, धर्म विधि, जस्ट बिकॉज यू नो आई एम हैविंग ज्ञान. Why should I follow dharma? That should not be there. One should follow the bhikshacharya also as per the rules of dharma shastra. Evam guru seva mano na managapi mano vikrutam vikrutim apadyeta. So evam gurum seva manaha. One who has this surrender, you know, I am doing it because shastra says it, I am doing it because guru says it, then the mind will become softer, you know, and it will understand the subtle things. Otherwise, there will be a lot of superficial thoughts going on. Those will block the study also. So, managapi mano vikritim apadyeta. Then the mind will not keep on jumping here and there. The monkey mind, you know, sits on in a particular place, and then it becomes yogya, shasana yogya. Then one really becomes a shishya. Yada chirakalam evam sevyamano guruhu prasidati tada tat svayam pratiksha svajijnyasam tasmai nivedaye. Then after serving the guru, when the guru is happy, then one should ask for what is a purpose. Swamin namaste nataloka bandho karunya sindhum patitam bhavabdhau mam uddharatmiya kataksha drushtya rujyati karunya sudha bhivrushtya. So this is from, I think, Viveka Chudamani. How should one, you know, ask for the teaching? So Swamin, hey Swamin, namaste, tasmai namaste, you namaskara to te. So te is tasmai, tasmai namaste, te namaste, nataloka bandha. So he is bandhu for everyone. So loka bandhu, karunya sindhu, he is the ocean of compassion. And bhavabdo patitam, I have one who has fallen in samsara, mom, that kind of me, uddhara, you uplift me. Atmiya kataksha drushtya, you know, looking upon me as your own, you know, just as you would look at your own, consider me as your own and look at me in that manner. Rujya atikarunya sudhavi drushtya. And then, just like there is the nectar, you know, the nectar which is fed to somebody who is in trouble. Medicine given, and at the highest level it is amrita. So that amrita, as the amrita is given, the amrita should not be in bits and pieces. He says, you know, let there be amrita dhara or vrishti, like rains, you know, let them pour. Ityadi stuti purvakam prashnecham nivedayet. Then one should ask the prashna after praising, you know. In Rudra also there is first namaka, then chamaka. Chamaka is, you know, chame chame, all, give me everything. As a laukika, I want everything. There are some 300 odd things which one asks in chamaka. But before that, one praises same Rudra where one is asking. So namakam first. Similarly, here also the same thing. Ityadi stuti purvakam prashnecham nivedayet. Yadi pruchet anumatim. Yadi anumatim pruchet dadya tada. So one. If one asks anumati, and then tada swasamsho nivedaniya. If one, the anumati of what has been asked, purchet anumatim dadyat, if the guru agrees, okay, I will teach you, then tada swasamsho nivedaniya. So even before asking, there is a way to ask. You know, even in laukika we say, you know, may I ask, you know. It is not that, you know, just shoot out a question and then, you tell me. It is not, the tone should be of wanting to learn. It is not to test the guru. There are some people who ask questions, but then say, oh, yeah, I already knew this. Why don't you tell me what you know before asking? Some people just say, you know, you just repeat what you have said. Why? So there are people who keep on asking, but never have the attitude of learning. They want to question, but they don't want to learn. So here also, even before asking the guru, the shishya should express gratitude that having found someone to answer his questions, also one should be lucky. Many people do not know how to handle questions. So if you find someone who is helping you out, we should be thankful, you know. We should be thankful to even have access. In modern age, access is easy. We don't have to travel. You know, today we can call up someone, WhatsApp, ask. If we know someone who can answer, all this is available today, we should be more and more thankful. That is the idea here. Shishyasya, okay, I think did I miss something? Yeah. Oh, Shishyasya ananta janmantararjita punya punya vashat shri sadguru krupaya kevalam dhanadyanapekshaya yadi upadishet. If the guru teaches without expecting anything, you know, it is not tuition. It is not tuition as in, I pay you, you teach me. It is not that. The seva is the samarpana to this offering oneself and wanting to learn for moksha. That itself is dhana. That itself is the offering of tuition. It is not, you know, give and take in terms of you buy knowledge. Knowledge cannot be bought. So here, Shishyasya Ananta Janmantara Arjita, the Punya which has been earned through many Janmas. Even in Viveka Chudani, Bhagavad Padacharya says this. It is not easy. Several Janmas Punyas are fructifying in finding, even being, having Advaita Vasana. Advaita Vasana itself does not come in. And even after getting Advaita Vasana, finding the Guru who can teach Aikya, who himself has had Sakshatkara, who is a Shrotriya Brahmanishta, is after exhausting so much of Papa, and when Punya starts fructifying, Punya Punja Vashat, Sri Sadguru Krupaya Kevalam Dhanadhyana Pekshaya Yadi Upadishet. Kevalam, Kevalam, Krupaya, Krupaya Kevalam. Only due to compassion. And Pooja Swamiji used to say here, an extra ounce of compassion. It is not general compassion, that Daya of Swami Dayananda, Daya, his name Daya was fitting there. As his guru said, what else will I name him? That compassion is because to see, when you have Aikya Jnana, to see a Dvitiya, Shishya who is afflicted in Dukkha, where the Swarupa has no Dukkha, seeing the other's affliction and teaching them, that itself is an extra ounce of compassion. Tada Uttamadhikarinaha Tasya Niratishaya Kalyanam Jayeta. Then the benefit that the Shishya would get, not the Guru, the Shishya would get is the Uttamadhikari, becoming an Uttamadhikari with the Punya fructifying, and then Niratishaya Kalyanam. There is nothing more auspicious, Shubha, than this Aikya Jnana. Tatra Uttamottama Brahmanishtha Shri Sadguru Sevayaha Phalam Dvidham. So there is a twofold result or gain from Sadguru Seva. Shri Sadguru ho Niratishe Prasada Labaha Prathamam Phalam. So Niratishe Prasada Labaha. The Guru teaching, and that itself is the first phala Shri Sadguru Niratishe Prasada Labaha. The grace of the Guru in the form of teaching. At least it is in the form of the teaching, that is the Prathama Phala. Dvitiyam phalam tu kama krodhadi sarva malanivrutti dvara antakkarana shuddhihi. Antakkarana shuddhi also takes place through Guru Seva. We have seen this, how the antakkarana becomes softer and sukshma. It is able to understand sukshma teaching. Etad dvayam api uttamadhikarana shishyasya siddham eva bhavati. Uttamadhikari will get it. Others will get it in time, because there are other doshas in the antakkarana which do not go easily. They need a lot of effort on the part of the shishya. The karma yoga should continue. Guraveyo manovacho karyarthadi samarpyatam sevate bhavati brahma prasadatishayat guroho. So guroho atishya prasadat, prasadatishayat guroho prasadatishayat brahma bhavati. One will become brahma because he is teaching that Aikya through which he himself as though became Brahma. Brahma Veda Brahma Eva Bhavati. Similarly, Shishya also Brahma Eva Bhavati. How? Guraveyaha Manovachau. Manas and Vak. Karyarthadi Samarpyatam. Karya and Artha. Adi Padena. Whatever one really values, all that should be offered. Samarpyatam. Sanyasya and Samarpya. Both. Sevate. One who does Guru Seva, Saha, this Yaha is Saha, we can supply and say Saha Guru Prasadati Shayat Brahma Eva Bhavati. Yastu Mano Vak Kaya Dhanadikam Shri Sudgurave Samarpya Ahoratram Tam Shushrushate Sahi Brahma Eva Bhavati. One who stays in the Guru Kala and continuously serves the Guru, for that jnana, he gets that jnana, he taps the grace of Ishwara and the Guru, gets the drishta phala as well as adrishta phala, and then Brahma eva bhavati by Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. Sadgurushcha asmai sahayam karoti. And Sadguru helps him see that he is Brahma. Iti Shri Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati Virachite Vichara Sagare Guru Shishya Swarupa Nirupanam Nama Tritiya Starangaha. The third chapter, as translated by translated and with additional information of Shruti and Smriti Smriti Pramana as supplied by Shri Vasudeva Brahmendra Saraswati Swami, who created this Sanskrita Vichara Sagara, in that the Guru Shishya Swarupa Nirupanam Nama Tritiya Staranga. The Lakshana of the Guru and Shishya are talked in this chapter. This is over. We'll look at the fourth chapter, where the story and the dialectic starts, which is made up by Sadhu Nischala Dasa. He creates a story to as a foundation in which the teaching takes place, as taught in the Shruti and Sampradaya. And the progress is for different types of adhikaris. So initially for Uttama Adhikari and so on, it will cater to all types of adhikaris. Unlike, you know, some Upanishads are committed only to Uttama Adhikaris. We know by the question itself. For example, Keno Upanishad, Mandukya Upanishad. Mandukya Upanishad caters to Uttama Adhikaris. Then Karika also explains a lot, but then still it is also at a very high level. Then Keno Upanishad also, you look from the question itself. Keno Upanishad question itself. Kena Eshitam Preshitam Patati Manaha. The question itself is at a very advanced level. We struggle to understand the question. How did the Shishya land there? Because the Shishya is an Uttama Adhikari. Comparatively, I mean, Uttama Adhikari, these three categories are not, you know, exact. There is an overlap and there is a gradation even within the Adhikarityam. But this text caters to everyone. And some Upanishads, you know, even in Keno Upanishad, you know, Upanishadam Bhobruhi, after the Upanishad is taught, then Shishya asks, you know, teach me Upanishad. So Upanishad has been taught, but then some obstacles are there for that Upasana is prescribed. So that Madhyama Adhikaris and Adhama Adhikaris can also get there. Kramena, sequentially, they can also get to the Keneshitam Preshitam Manaha, Patati Manaha. So one can get to that level. Some Upanishads cater to it at the end, but it has to be handled by the Sampradaya, how it has to be taught. There is only one way of teaching, but then the prakriyas vary, methodologies vary, although the jnana is same. However, the methodologies and prakriyas vary. Here also, there will be various tools used to teach and all sorts of adhikaris, starting with an Uttama Adhikari in the fourth chapter. The story builds up. We'll see that in the next part. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam nama rupyo adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyatva nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadeva ahannamattonyat iti me nischita matihi. Any questions? Looks like there are some hiccups with the screen and audio today. Can you all see the next part?
Hari Om.